Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam and this video is about carotid artery Doppler ultrasound. On ultrasound, mainly the common carotid artery and the internal carotid artery are examined as most of the pathologies occur within these vessels. Here is a longitudinal image of the common carotid artery. And here it is showing the normal intima-media thickness. The normal intima-media thickness is less than 1 mm. And over here we have an abnormal intima-media thickness. When it is more than 1 mm, there is increased risk of atherosclerosis and plaque formation. Here is a longitudinal view showing the common carotid artery and its branches, the external carotid artery and the internal carotid artery. This is the carotid bifurcation. And over here we have a carotid plaque. It can appear as a hypoechoic structure within the lumen. It may be partially calcified. And these calcified areas appear hyperechoic. Here is another image of a plaque in the internal carotid artery. It is a calcified plaque and it is hyperechoic. It also has posterior acoustic shadowing. Carotid plaque ulceration is difficult to see on ultrasound. But in some cases, if it is prominent, it can be seen. Its features include irregular shape of the plaque, and there will be hypoechoic defects within the plaque. This type of plaque is more likely to cause embolization. Now we will look at Doppler analysis of internal carotid artery. This is the normal color flow within the internal carotid artery. And down here is the spectral waveform. It is a low resistance waveform with a broad systolic peak and forward diastolic flow. The peak systolic velocity or PSV in normal cases is less than 125 centimeters per second, and the end diastolic velocity or EDV is less than 40 centimeters per second. The ICA to CCA PSV ratio must be less than 2, that is the ratio of PSV between internal carotid artery and the common carotid artery. In this image, the PSV is slightly more than 50 centimeters per second and the EDV is around 25 centimeters per second. And this is an image of internal carotid artery stenosis, a 0 to 49% stenosis. In this case, the PSV and the EDV values will be normal. The ICA by CCA PSV ratio will also be normal, but a plaque will be seen within the lumen, or we will find increased intimal thickening. Here the PSV is around 100 centimeters per second and the EDV is around 40 centimeters per second. In a 50 to 69% stenosis, the PSV will be between 125 to 230 centimeters per second. The EDV will be between 40 to 100 centimeters per second. The plaque will be visualized, or increased intimal thickening will be seen. And the ICA by CCA PSV ratio will be between 2 to 4. Here the PSV is between 250 and 300 centimeters per second, and the EDV is between 50 to 100 centimeters per second. A stenosis of more than 70% but less than near occlusion is considered if the PSV is greater than 230 centimeters per second and a large visible plaque is seen along with prominent lumen narrowing. Here we can see a very small amount of flow right next to a large plaque. It indicates significant lumen narrowing. Here is a case of near occlusion. There is reduced flow in the internal carotid artery. The flow velocities may be undetectable or greatly reduced. Also, there is significant lumen narrowing. We can see a very small waveform on spectral Doppler. This type of waveform may be seen in near occlusion. In total ICA occlusion, the plaque is obstructing the entire lumen. No flow will be detected on color Doppler or spectral Doppler. In this case, no flow is detected on spectral Doppler. This indicates total occlusion. The sample volume is placed at the site of stenosis and no flow is detected. This image is showing normal blood flow in a common carotid artery using color Doppler. And this is a case of common carotid artery dissection. There is a tear in the intima layer of common carotid artery. On ultrasound, two lumens may be seen in some cases with a visible dissection flap. This is the dissection flap and this gives an appearance of two lumens. This is the first lumen and this is the second lumen. Here is an image without color Doppler applied. We can see a dissection flap floating within the lumen of common carotid artery. This is a feature of dissection. This is a transverse view showing the common carotid artery and jugular vein. And over here we have CCA dissection in transverse view with color Doppler applied. We can see the two lumens with a dissection flap in the middle. We may also find some color mixing on color Doppler. Here are images of common carotid artery stents in transverse view and longitudinal view. The stent appears as a mesh-like structure lining the lumen of the carotid artery. In this image, we can see an abnormal stent. There is narrowing of the lumen. Some stents can cause stenosis of the artery after a period of time. On spectral Doppler, if the PSV at the site of stenosis is more than 300 centimeters per second, it is considered a 70 to 80% stenosis. In this case, the PSV has crossed the 300 centimeters per second mark. So this can indicate a stenosis of 70 to 80%. The normal diameter of the common carotid artery is usually between 4 to 7 millimeters. And this is a case of common carotid artery aneurysm. there is abnormal dilation of the artery. We can see an enlarged lumen. A pseudoaneurysm can also occur in carotid arteries, but it is very rare. It is usually caused by trauma, or it can be a complication of a procedure. We will see a thin connection between the pseudoaneurysm, which may appear as a sac-like structure right next to the artery, with a thin connection between this structure and the artery. We will also find Doppler signals within this pseudoaneurysm. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.